when are we going to be thinking of this? Yes, we have persistence, but also maybe we have some symptoms that point to the presence of a hernia. So what are those symptoms? Well, this is when an individual is maybe reporting to you that as they're doing their exercises, or maybe even as their baby, who's now maybe closer to a year old, kind of gets close to their abdominal wall, they actually have pain. Like they have actual sensitivity and pain. We know diastasis is not associated with pain, right? It's not associated with a threat output such as pain. And so when we're having pain, you know, in this clinical picture, it makes us think, might there be a hernia there? We also think of the symptom of nausea, right? So a woman might say, yeah, you know, I've started trying to progress my exercises, but I'm trying to do this. And literally, I almost feel like a bit nauseous when I go into this movement, right? So pain and nausea, somewhere through the middle of the abdominal wall, which is where the ventral hernias will pop up, most often right around the umbilicus, that should sort of set our radar off that we really want to make sure we're ruling out for hernias. Because of course, diastasis, even though it's often discussed as a gap or a separation, it isn't, right? Diastasis really means that the superficial abdominal muscles have displaced, the linea alba has thinned, has widened, its architecture might be compromised, but there isn't actually a separation happening unless there is a hernia. If there is a hernia, this is actually when we have a tissue separation, right? So we're thinking of pain and nausea for that.